In lesson 2.1, students put room temperature washers in a cup with hot water and see that the temperature of both the washers and the water changes. The question is, why does this happen? What's going on the molecular level? Some of the big ideas covered in the lesson are that energy can be transferred from one substance to another through conduction. The idea is that faster moving particles hit slower moving particles and increase their speed, and that increases their temperature. So let's take a look at how this works. First, we use large metal washers and we take their temperature as best you can, and they're about room temperature, and then you place those in hot water. You don't use much water because you want the temperature of the water to change. And then students see almost immediately that the temperature of the water begins to go down. Now, we also have kids take the temperature of the washers when they come out of the water, and they see that the temperature of the washers goes up. And the question is, why does this happen? We use an analogy of like when you put a metal spoon into hot soup, and if you touch it to your lips, you know it's pretty hot. So what's going on there? So the room temperature spoon has slower moving particles, and the hot soup has faster moving ones, but the faster moving particles contact the slower ones and speed them up. They transfer some of their energy. So the temperature of the spoon increases and the temperature of the soup decreases. But the temperature of the soup decreases only slightly because there's a whole lot more soup than there are particles in the spoon. Also, the reason why they don't change temperature the same amount is they're made of different substances. We'll get to that in a minute. On the activity sheet, the students are given a drawing of this metal spoon, and the particles are moving at room temperature. They have two motion lines, but the particles in the soup have three motion lines, moving faster. So the kids draw in the motion lines for the soup. They should have fewer motion lines, and for the spoon should have more, showing that the temperature of the spoon goes up and the temperature of the soup goes down. We also have a simulation in middleschoolchemistry.com to get kids to understand the idea of what is temperature anyway. So let's go there really quickly. And in this simulation, it works best if you cycle once through the cold, medium, and hot, and then use it with students. So here, let's take a look at the cold. And obviously the particles are moving slowly, but there's a couple with a little more energy. The amount of energy is indicated by the color difference. As you go to purple, pink, red, that's all getting hotter and hotter. These blues are moving pretty slowly. That indicates cold. Now, if we go to medium, we see that there are some particles with more energy. And you can see as they hit each other, they transfer energy. They change color, which indicates they change speed. And at any given temperature, it's the average kinetic energy of the particles. You can see that as we get warmer and warmer, here I'll go to hot, there's just on average, there's more of them that are moving faster and have a different color, a hotter color in this case. So let's just pause it, and you can make that point with students that in a substance, the particles are moving at different speeds, but the temperature is the average kinetic energy. In the teacher background, at this link right here, there's a little discussion about specific heat and heat capacity. Basically, both those concepts are that because substances are different, they have a certain amount of energy will increase their temperature by a certain amount. So in the washers and water example, even though the water may have decreased by 10 degrees, the washers won't necessarily increase by 10 degrees. The energy was transferred, but it takes a different amount of energy to change the temperature of a given substance by a different amount because substances are all different. Now, if you're in an NGSS state, the performance expectation, MSPS 1.4, says that develop a model that predicts and describes changes in particle motion, temperature, and state of a pure substance when thermal energy is added or removed. Well, students do develop a model, in this case, of conduction, and they see that when faster moving particles hit slower ones, energy is transferred, and the temperature of the slower ones goes up, and the temperature of the faster ones goes down. And if you look at the foundation boxes here, you'll see the kids develop a model to describe phenomena. They get the idea of the transfer of energy is due to temperature difference in conduction. That temperature is a measure of the average kinetic energy. They see that in the simulation. And as far as cause and effect goes, if the effect is that the temperature of the washers goes up and the temperature of the water goes down. The cause is particle motion and conduction, that there was a transfer of energy between the faster moving particles to the slower moving particles. So, thanks for watching and good luck with the lesson.